This is a disclaimer. No fantasy creatures were harmed in the making of this video. Only my pride. So let's get ready to play the easiest game ever, Elden Ring.
Hey, hey, way.
Hello and welcome back to some more fun in the sun. Yes, we're playing some more Elden Ring. And as we left off last time, you know, we were fighting that big monkey man, yes. Well, he bet us, so what we're going to do is we're not going to fight him. How's that sound? Sounds good to me. So, what we're going to do instead is, Monkey Man's down there, yes? We have the Monkey Man. So we're going to avoid him, okay? We're going to actually run past him, because, well, no, I'm not a coward. No, stop saying that, okay? We're going to go around him. We'll come back to him later. We will come back. We're going to go this way. So we're going to head through this wooded area. There is obviously these guys guarding it, but let's face it, they're easy. Because this game is easy. Yeah? Game is easy? Good. I'll try not to say that too much this video, but the game is easy. But yeah, let's carry on through here then. There's another wee guy hiding in the bush. And he's gone. Epic. Right, and up past this little clearing, this is what we're going to be doing here. So, this little encampment here. Up to the left here we have the gates to Stormvale. We're not going in there now. We're going to clear this camp out. But there's a few things we need to do before we can do that. We're going to this site of grace over here. We're going to pop it. So, now that we have this done and we're down at this camp, you know, at the foot of Stormvale, yes, right about here. What we're going to do is we're going to rest, because this actually allows us to finally level up. We're actually allowed to level up now. How epic is that? So when you rest here, there's going to be a little cutscene. You're going to be sitting here at your little site of grace. It's going to be a great time had by all, I'm sure. You know, resting away, and then this beautiful lady is just going to appear. Look at her. Oof. Oof. Look at her. Now she is going to allow us to level up. So. That sounds fun, doesn't it? We can actually progress! We can actually get a wee bit better at this game. I know, it's shocking. I didn't expect to get how many bosses? Like, technically 3 bosses in, and now we can level up. You know, that's just bizarre. But never mind. So we're going to talk to her, and she's going to also give us this little ring, thing here. And that's going to allow us to ride on the horsey. So we actually have a horsey as well. Now, I love using the horsey. However, it has got me killed so many times, it is unbelievable. But anyway, let's show off. Here's horsey. So, horsey can run quite fast, can do double jumps, you know. Brilliant. Brilliant mechanic for a Souls game, you know. Little horse, so you can actually get to ledges and stuff, which by the way is the reason I die the most, because the amount of ledges I fell off using this horse, I actually die more to gravity than I do enemies in this game. However, we are now going to travel back to that church we seen right at the start, just for this little cutscene. This way, tarnished. May I have a... And now that we're here, this little witch person, another beautiful little lady, is going to show up and basically offer us a little thing so that we can summon spirit creatures to help us, which is going to be needed if I am not using magic, because they will draw their attention, helping me with bosses, so this is also needed. So now we can summon wolves. Isn't that fun? Some wolves to come join us. Great. Right, okay, what do we need to do? Equip the wolves, yes. Let's do that, and let's head back to where we just were. Okay, now it is time to actually take on this camp. Let's see if I actually am good enough at this game to take this camp, but we are going to bring the wolves with us. The wolves are coming. You've got to love them. Come on, Wills. Let's get into this fight. Let's go. Let's go, boys. Let's go. Alright, get him. Get him. That's it. Just keep jumping up. Keep staggering them. That's what to do. I love it. I love it. Right, so now that we have the wolves, I mean, that makes this a little bit easier. It's just a wee bit easier to get around here now. We're going to take out this wee felly. This wee felly here. Oh, he's got a shield, though. I didn't like shield people, but never mind. There we go. The dogs were a bit late to the party, but not to worry. I've taken care of it. We're going to go inside this little chest here for a greatsword, I believe. And that was correct. There we go. Wee greatsword that I can't quite equip yet, but you know. Maybe now that I can level up, that is a possibility. Right, down here, in the middle here, there is a wee guy that plays the trumpet. Now he will alert everyone to your presence. Grab this map, yes. He'll alert everyone to your presence and they will all come for you at once if you let him play his little tune. And as you see, he got his little tune off. So, now every little enemy in this bloody area is now coming to try and kill me. And, I mean, there's a lot of them. They're hiding in wee corners, but there is a lot. Especially this guy, he's big, he hops. And, oof, just annoying. But anyway, let's see what we can do here. I don't like to alert all of them at the same time, it makes this rather difficult, but never mind, let's see what we can do. If I can take out you, never mind, there's one coming behind me. Dogs, attack! Help me! Okay, I'm dead. Excellent. Fun times. Okay, let's try this again, but let's do it with a little bit of a musical number, shall we? Thank you. Okay, so here's the reason we're really here. It's to come down into the basement, because usually these kind of ruined type areas encampments, they have a hidden treasure somewhere, usually downstairs. So if you pop down here, you'll probably get something, which is an ash of war, and you get a little knife, so you can put the ashes of war onto your weapons, which are like skills, if you will, you know, it's like adding a skill. Okay, so now I have leveled up a bit. I have a new sword. Looking nice, isn't it? Looking nice. So I did level up my dexterity just a little, so I could wield this great sword. Let's just give it a wee go as we pass here. Pop. I mean, not terrible. I mean, it would help if I actually connect one of these hits, but you know what? We'll leave them now. We're going to carry on, and we are heading into Stormvale Castle. Yes. So we're going to head through this gate. First, we're going to stop off at the Site of Grace. There we go, like that. And now, as we enter, it looks like there's a few archers and stuff, but if you look up, there is also a troll thing waiting. This is a warning. If anyone suffers from motion sickness, well, I'm sorry, but deal with it. Let's go!